simple question, who's actually in charge of the church? A simple question, but people have all sorts of answers, of course. However, you know, and I know, that the one in charge of the church is our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. It's his church. He laid down his life for her, and he is the head of the church. How does he rule over his church? How does he tell us how to worship him, how to serve him? He does so through his word, empowered by his spirit, and he teaches us. And that's why in our churches the word of God is so central, why we read the scriptures, why we explain the scriptures and apply the scriptures, and why we live by the scriptures. And it's not our business to interfere with that and to say that the scriptures are wrong or that he's not telling us the right thing. Now, this present debate we're having and this present real schism that's occurred is really about authority, the authority of God's word. Yes, the presenting issue is to do with sexuality, but that's not the key issue here. The key issue, and we've seen this from the beginning, is about the word of God. I was once speaking to an African leader, and he said to me, and I've heard this from others as well, you Westerners, you bought us the Bible, you got us to believe the Bible, you got us to change to fit in with what the Bible says, and now you're saying to us, the Bible no longer matters. Well, it's a fair point, isn't it? There are so many who are now thinking that perhaps the world and its ways can trump the Word of God. But I don't think that's the path of wisdom. I don't think that's how the Lord rules his church. And I think that's why we've got to be so strongly committed and trusting to the Bible. And here's another point too. The Bible and the gospel of the Lord Jesus go together. You can't really separate them. The Apostle Paul says at one point that people came preaching another Jesus. You see, it's possible to draw a portrait of Jesus, even to preach a Jesus who is not the biblical Jesus, who is not the authentic Jesus. We know who the real one is because he comes to us from the Bible, speaking to us in the Bible, and described for us in the Bible. That's why it's so important to believe in the authority of God's word and to submit to it. And that's why Gafcon's so important, because what we're standing for, when all is said and done, is the authority of God's word, the way in which the Lord Jesus rules his church, and therefore the precious saving gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, who came into the world to save sinners.